Hey guys, what's going on and welcome back to episode 31 of Crine. Let's get started. So today we're going to be working on a lot more of Crine. This video is going to be taking within the course of a week or so. So there's going to be a lot of progress in this episode, I am hoping. Depends on how many streams I'm able to get in. Because each time that I say that I'm going to be right back, it really have been like several days in between each segment. And there will be a lot of progress done. So what is going to happen is I'm probably going to be working some more on the outside nature. We'll get to this in just a second about what we've done here and some more things like that. I've worked on the interior inside of that. I'm working on the interior of the barracks. And so what I'm planning on doing is starting the second part of the castle here. So this is something that a lot of you have been really excited about. Now, since this episode is going to be pretty, it's going to be a lot of extra stuff, so expect this episode to be pretty long. You guys know how long it is, but I don't know how long it's going to be yet. So depending on, it all depends on how much recording I'm able to get in and what it all looks like. I'm really not happy with this terrain. I really don't like it. Ever since that I figured out how to do custom scripts and such, this is going to probably change a whole lot. So I'm probably just going to annihilate this entire bit of terrain right here. Just completely destroy it. And then we're going to rebuild it in a new method. And I'll try to show you guys a little bit of how I had done that. I'm going to be using what's called custom scripts, which is a very useful command in order to make very nice, natural looking terrain. But the thing is, it's going to look a little bit different than the rest of this terrain here, so we'll have to try to blend that in somehow. But overall, I'm pretty happy with what's going on here. We got the foliage around the outside and things like that. This is what we worked on last episode up here. I've changed the harp a little bit. Now, this is pretty much a duplicate of what Helen came up with, because what I came up with the last episode wasn't near as good. But this is 100% Helen's design right here. I just thought that this is just a really cool design. I love this harp. So, anyway, I put Helen the Harpist right there. So, she's just, I love her designs. It's just incredible. But anyways, we got a little balcony up here, really cool. And then you come down here and there's a nice little parapet and causeway. You guys have seen that last episode. There really hasn't been any changes to that part. But what we're going to be showing you now in this part of the update, part of the episode, is the inside of this barracks portion here. And I'm going to be showing this outside, but we're going to show you guys this first. Now, right here is just sort of like some grasslands and some repetitive bushes here and there. I'm going to be working on this some more. I've got to figure out ways to break it up and add in more variation. Things like rocks, maybe little mulberry trees and things like that. Just little trees. Like, I'm thinking about adding in little things like, where is it? Little things like this, little trees like this around. I think that would look pretty good. Maybe little pine tree saplings around. That would look nice, I think. Just kind of like an overgrown kind of area, but no trees, like no tall trees. Excuse me. That right there is going to be kind of the only tree in this area. There might be maybe several others sort of scarce and scattered around. But overall, I think this is doing pretty well. I've switched up some of the biomes. There's going to be some more grasses and things in here to give it more variation. Now, here is a marsh area that I really wanted to do. I think it turned out pretty good. You have little spots of cattails. You have the lily pads in there, and these little kind of pools of water where the water would collect. You see, all of this would drain into here. And then when this would overflow, it would go down here and into the moats. So that works out. And as you can see, there's another little pool of water here, and it would go into the moat. Other things like that, that's just kind of how things work. This is sort of like a lowlands here. There's nowhere for the water to go. Therefore, it would become very wet and marsh-like. And that's why marshes are formed, is because there's nowhere for the water to go. And it just kind of pools there. And also, I think it depends on the soil. Sometimes the soil doesn't dissolve or absorb the water quickly as, say, other soil. But I think it mainly has to do with runoff and where the water can go. So yeah, that's our wetlands and sort of area over here. and got a little nice little thing over here. This was made by Pigland, just a little hideout for a hobo or something, who knows. Someone could be in here and do whatever they want to do. Apparently there's a rat lives in here, so yes, Mr. Rat lives there. And we've got a hawk right here. But other than that, there really hasn't been any change to this over here. I haven't worked on these crops or anything. I did get some feedback on what people think. Someone suggested that there should be a lake here, which I agree with. I feel like this area is more or less a lowlands, just like the marshes. So this is probably going to turn out to be some sort of wet area here. And I'll move these fields around to accommodate that. And I'll probably manipulate the terrain to make it more... make it work like that a little bit better. So other than that, nothing really going on over there. And we're gonna go back over here and let's look through Crine real fast. Let's actually walk down this path and just take in the sights. Now, I'm gonna say again, I've probably said this in previous episodes, I'm still not fully happy with Crine. There's still things that I really want to do and change about it, but overall, the style is, you know, I want to try to adopt a more realistic style. I want to try to work on my, for the longest time, I've been just kind of building whatever I want to build, fantasy, it's just like whatever works for me. And now I want to start kind of challenging myself and work on the realism aspect and try to make things look like it would seem in real life. Now, obviously, Crine isn't going to... work like that, because Crine is not a castle that you would see in real life, but it is what it is. This has been a long-term project of mine, and I just don't feel like just throwing it off the throwing it away and not doing it anymore. So there is that, but like I said, I want to work on this part back here. So let's go ahead and check this out real fast, what I did on the interior of the castle. That way we can get this segment over with, so this video can be 1 or 2 minutes shorter than it would have been. So let's go ahead and change over to some lighter shaders. There we go. And let's go in here and check it out. So if you guys don't recognize this, this here is the barracks dining area. This is where some of the guards at least would eat and drink and do their thing. And we're gonna go ahead and go into the that portion of the castle that sort of comes out. So this here is part of it. We come out this side, and as you can see here, we got the different arrow slits looking down towards the causeway. So this is the lowest level that you can get to on this part of the castle. Now, I might make even lower levels depending. But as you can see, there's lots of arrows, there's some armor stands in here. I wasn't able to get skulls or helmets in this world for some reason. I don't know why, but anyways, I wasn't able to do that, so I just had to deal with these. Now, if there wasn't biomes, I would pimp these things out. I would make them look real nice. It would be so nice to have the armor stands in 1.9 or etc. and above, but that's not the case. So, but yeah, anyways, there's that. So again, down here, for those of you that don't remember, this here is the cellars of Crine, not worked on really at all. These are all supposed to be stone, but biomes again, so probably gonna have to just remove all of those and just have to deal with it. But yeah, this here is the cellars. We're not gonna go through there too much, because this was long time ago added in. Monsterfish had helped me with these quite a while ago. So now we're gonna go back up and we're gonna go into this part. So this here is an armory. People helped me a good bit with figuring out what colors would work out in here, and I worked with the white and the Italian stone. I really thought that worked out. It adds in a good bit of contrast, and especially with the brick ceiling here. Oh, that looks so nice. I love the look of this room. It's very Italian looking, if you ask me. I think it looks really nice. So then over here, we have a lot more armor stands, and we have like a little map here. And then this would be kind of like a watch post where guards would use like a telescope and sort of look out. You know, it's a kind of a good place because they can see out that arrow slit, see out that one, and then there's this guard over here. So it's a really good place for guards to watch so that they don't get rained on or anything. And I really like how it looks in here. Well, not so much in here, but I love how this looks in here. We got arrows, you got spears and stuff like that. Now, I don't think that this will be the only armory. I think there will be another. I didn't know quite what to put in this room because it just seemed like an odd spot for a room because this would be one of the first places to be attacked. So I don't know, I just put an armory here because it just kind of made sense to me at the time because this would be attacked first. So, and then there are the windows around. If I can get through here, why am I not being able to get through there? I don't know, so we're gonna go like that. All right, and then you come out through here and you got the arrow slits again looking down the sides. And then you have those little like window covers on the outside and you can use these levers to close them. Oh, excuse me. And now the last thing that I'm going to show you is the top floor, which we're gonna have to get to going up this way. Still gotta work on this hallway here, figure out or work in some details and things. And also another thing I've noticed is I need to add in some privies. I don't have any privies in here. So we come in here, this here is this room. I need to work on these rafters a little more, give them a little bit more detail and work on them some more. But I think that over time, this room's gonna look really nice. I didn't finish it because this was like at the end of one of my streams and I had to just, I had to go abruptly, so I wasn't able to finish that on time. You come out here and this is the front porch. So that is all of that building right there. And hopefully by the end of this episode, this room will be finished. So, but anyways, let's go ahead and get working on this. I'm not sure what will be done by the time I come back, but there will be some done and let's get started. Okay guys, it's a day later and we have gotten a good bit done since in only a day. We've only streamed about 4 hours and we just finished and we have gotten some nice progress. And I'm looking forward to showing you guys that. So if you guys are not following me over on Twitch, I would sincerely suggest that you guys go follow the link down below in the description over to my Twitch and hit that follow button because that is where I build this monstrosity is only on Twitch and you guys can watch and be there and suggest and help me keep going. And it's a nice environment over there. I really enjoy the community. Everyone seems very happy and they seem to enjoy it. So, but yeah, that's where we have been building and we have made a big change and that big change is the gatehouse. And I'm very happy with how it's turned out. I'm still kind of iffy on how this top part looks, but overall I think that it really has a nice look to it. It looks a lot more intimidating than what it did before. Like before it looked like this spindly piece of art, but now it looks like a solid gate that will withstand a siege. And it looks quite nice. You got the nice, I still maintained the former beam design coming out, the portcullis design, etc. Or not the portcullis, I'm sorry. The drawbridge design that I had used, or that I wanted to use. And I think that this works really well. And then you come in through, you got the portcullis and things like that. So I like that on very nice. So what else is there to see? You come down the causeway here and it leads over to this bridge. This is another change. I removed this drawbridge here. I didn't think it made much sense. So I changed that up and I used a more of a bridge design. Now it's not like something you can retract or not something that can add to the defensive nature, but what I'm thinking is maybe just this part of the road, maybe they did have a road here at one time but then it got washed away. Maybe I can show evidence of that, like maybe I can have rubble from the causeway down here kind of all torn up and everything and washed away because of some rainstorm or something. I don't know. I think that that works out better. And I also narrowed the causeway that goes around this part here. I just thought it was a little too wide since, you know, this is all just four wide here. There's really no reason to have this so wide out on this side. So I made this moat much larger here, which I like a lot. I really like how that really separated that more, so now it would be much harder for enemies to get from there to there and try to scale this wall into the castle. So still we got a very defensible castle going on here. And so the top is flat, lots of room for soldiers to get together and shoot it down. You got these little murder holes up here where they can shoot down the enemy. I just realized that those stupid things are in the way, but I had to figure that out. That's something I'll have to figure out later on, but yeah, so there is that. Got several arrow loops along the sides of the gate, and they can shoot down on the enemies as they try to come in. And so, let me destroy that. Yes. Is that right? Yes, that's right. Okay, and then another thing that I want to show you is that I changed up this because there was like four bodies here before, but I changed it up. I made it so there's two nooses. I feel like that looks better. It's more variation, looks a little bit better in my opinion. Another thing I changed that was a big change is I removed this entire wall here. Remember there's this wall that went across. I'm not done with this in here, of course, but this here is basically a way to separate the gatehouse from the main keep. So basically the gatehouse, everything over here and that whole building right there is, you know, one part of the castle. And then that tower that isn't finished and going all the way over here, all of that is the second part of the castle. There's two parts of this castle. And so that wall was basically causing an issue. Basically it was connecting this whole part of the castle to that part of the castle, and I didn't like that, so I removed that and I made it so that there was this little bridge that the defenders could just pull back, you know, once the garrison from the gatehouse retreats back across here, they could just pull that bridge back. They would close this grate, lock it, then they would close this door and lock it, and then they would just get over here on these arrow slits and shoot away. I might find out some other ways to make it more defensible, but overall I like how that looks. There used to be a bigger window here, but it was all glass, but I didn't like it being all glass, so I changed it to two arrow slits like that, and I think that works out quite well. So that was another big change. And of course this big tower in the middle, this is a big central tower. I want to figure out something specific to do with it. I'm not quite sure. You know, of course, we have a bell tower already. I'm not quite sure what specific thing we could do with this. It's probably just going to be for defensive purposes, and I might put a roof on top of it. It might make sense to put a roof on top and then maybe some fortifications around, and maybe some machicolations, as you can see here, with these murder holes and things like that. So other than that, I think that's really all that we had to update today, update on this segment. There is this, however, I made this larger as a, remember there was that horseshoe shaped tower here? I removed that and I made it so that there was this larger stairway to get up from the dining hall up to the ballroom floor. And of course this is a tiny ballroom floor, it's not very big at all, but still it's, you know, a ballroom floor, so I decided to just go ahead and make a larger stairway to get up there, and I will have to figure out what kind of roof to put on top. So that is all there is so far. I've not really done any more than that, but yeah, definitely guys, follow me over on Twitch. That's where you will see the progress for yourselves. And there is still a lot more to go. I think there's two or three more streams between now and the end of this episode, so more progress to come. Alrighty, so we have a few more changes now. I've added some more features to Akurine as we have streamed again recently, and so we're gonna go ahead and go through those, and right now you're looking at one of them. This here, I added in the tower. I finished it up. Well, I didn't finish it up. The interior is, of course, not done, but this here is a Novigrad-themed tower. For those of you that don't know what Novigrad is, it is it's the main city from the game Witcher 3. If you guys don't know what Witcher 3 is, then I would be surprised, but yes, this is a Witcher 3 themed tower, and I think it works really well there. I really like the design. I really like the overall look. Now there could be, of course, more detail and such, but I just kind of threw it in, and it works. It works. I enjoyed it. I also really like this right here, how there's sort of this canyons kind of feature coming through here. It feels much more cramped, so like the enemies would have to feel, you know, would feel much more cramped trying to get in through that gate. But I think that works. Now you also notice that I have updated textures. One of the updates in the new Conquest update will be biome specific arrow loops. So that is going to be something that I'm sure a lot of you are excited for. You know, we're tired of just these cobble arrow loops. Now we got you know, brick, we got, you know, all the different versions. I'll go ahead and show you really quick what we have. There's gonna be brick, pretty much most of the stones. Let me go ahead and turn chat off. There we go. We have sandstone, dark stone, you name it. We got most of the stones in there now. So yeah, there's a lot of new biome specific things down there. So yeah, that is a tower that we added in. So be prepared for that. I think that's 10.7 that's going to be coming out. 10.7 or 10.8, I don't know, but it's not out yet. It's just I have the automatic updater. If you guys donate to Monsterfish, you have the choice. You can get the automatic updater, and you can get the updates like before they even come out. So if you go over to Monsterfish's Planet Minecraft, which is linked down below, you will find and scroll down and you can donate to Monsterfish and you can get that feature. So go over, get some donations over to Monsterfish. He definitely deserves it. You know, while we would love to just do this for fun, Monsterfish, you know, he needs money to eat, needs money to live. And yes, so if you guys are have some money floating around, that would definitely help him out to give him a little bit of support. And it will keep him going. So also another thing that I changed here is this here is the barbican. I've changed this up. You'll notice that before this was just kind of a shabby little design here. Now we have changed this up to a more of a burg. If you guys don't know what a burg is, it's a German style castle sort of parapets here. You'll notice that it's like the Tudor and the little bit of the roof bit, and then you come around back and you got the little pillars. It looks really nice. I really like how it looks. I feel like, you know, obviously there's always room for improvement. I think that there's still more that I could do to make it look better, but overall for now that looks satisfactory. I think that works. And so when you come in through the main gate here, which would be near impossible feat, then you got to get through the barbican, and which would be another near impossible feat, because up there I'm thinking about putting a ballista. You know, they could put like you know, maybe they could come in with shields to try to cover themselves, like a turtle or whatever, to try to cover themselves from the being the onslaught of arrows from all around them. But you know, once if there's a ballista up there and it fires a large bolt down onto the enemies down here, I don't think any shield's going to protect them from that. So that will be an addition I think I'm going to be doing. Now, something else that I noticed is how this roof now, now some of you might not even, you know, say like, wow, Duncan, you know, I never really would have thought of that. But yeah, this here is kind of on the same level of this over here. And what I was thinking is like they could bring out like a ramp and then throw it across here and try to get onto the roof and then get in through the roof, you know, even come up through here, and then they could storm the top of the castle. And I don't want that. I'm probably going to figure out a new kind of way to do this roof, maybe bring it up higher or something of that nature. I just feel like there could be it could be a little bit more defensible, so I might be working on that in the near future. You'll also notice that I changed up the gatehouse a little bit. I added on this top bit. Before, I wasn't quite happy with it. It didn't look natural. It didn't look like it belonged on top. Now I feel like this belongs on top. It's a more of a gothic theme, as you can see with the little turrets here on each corner. That's more of a gothic kind of thing. Very decorative kind of turrets, not defensive at all. And then you got the little spikes on top. There's the gothic theme kind of reverberates across Crine. There's a lot of different things that sort of insinuate that there's a gothic theme going on, but it's not like a main theme. It's not like this is not a gothic castle, but gothic is a part of it. It is a part of it. Like, you'll notice, like, there's the gargoyles around. That's definitely purposeful. I like the gargoyles. Nice little architectural feature added into the overall design. And, you know, the spikes, of course, that's kind of a gothic thing. The roofs, like that roof right there, or even that bit up there, I kind of consider that gothic. You know, gothic style is more or less an artistic architectural style, and that's kind of what we're going on, a sharp architectural style. So yes, so that's that. And oh, there is one more thing. I did this right here. You'll notice that this balcony now has a border all the way around it. I really like how this is looking. I really think that it works. It sort of has an elven feel to it, if you know what I mean. Just this little terraced border. I forget what this is called, but it's a little border that goes around the balcony, and it looks much better, especially from the outside and such. It makes it look more enclosed and just yeah, it just works. Yeah, I think it just works right there. Originally, I had it as wood, and I was like, no, I think that stone looks a little bit better. And then we added in the roof to the stairway here, as we can all see. We'll go ahead and go inside and check this out. You come down, so I changed the stairs to wood. You go this way, and this leads you to the mosh pit. No, I'm kidding. The musician's stand. This is where they would serenade the people down there while they're eating. But yeah, that is that. And then this brings you up to the ballroom. Now, the ballroom, I am going to change. I'm going to take out this open bit here, and I'm going to make this entire upper floor into the ballroom. Because I feel like, even though I really like having this open bit here, I just feel like it doesn't work. I feel like it's just too much. I mean, this kind of looks like the smoking area up here. Like, this is where people would go to smoke over here. And then this is, I don't know. It just doesn't fit for me. So that's, I'm going to be changing that eventually. And see, the thing about me is I think I'm going to be taking Crying to Modded for doing the interiors. Because the interiors, some people enjoy the part where they like, you know, they enjoy the challenge behind making interiors with biomes, and then they gotta figure out, you know, how to make the conflicting biomes not conflict. And that's not me. I don't enjoy that. It is absolutely worthless to try to figure that out. For me, at least, I just don't enjoy it. If I'm gonna build, I'm gonna build. I don't want to have all these issues. And if there is an option where I don't have to have those issues, then that is an option that I will most likely take. Now, what was I gonna say? Now people will, you know, possibly look down on me. Oh, Dukan, if you use the mod, then you know, you're not as good as a builder or whatever. You know, you're afraid of biomes, and you know what? Oh well, it is what it is. It's just not what I enjoy, and it's all about what you enjoy. If you enjoy it, then that's what you should do. It's not, you know, you shouldn't feel tied to something or something like that. Just do what you like to do. That's what's important. But yeah, so this here is a Crying, and we will move on now. But yeah, so I'm about to stream today, and there will be more progress, and that will be that. I'm looking, some things that I want to do today is try to figure out ways to add in depth and more detail on this side of the Great Hall. And then I want to probably work on this area. I'm not quite happy with how this entire kind of section looks. This whole section needs a lot of work, so we are most likely going to be working on that as well. And other than that, I'm pretty happy with how Crying is looking now. So, yes, I will see you guys soon. Alrighty, much better now. I'm fairly happy with the results that we have come up with here. So, what you can see is I extended out some of the roof bits. I added in the stone dormers on either side of the middle portion here, which is a large Tudor dormer. And then I made this sort of balcony here, and goodness, what? This is all supposed to be Extreme Hills biomes. I don't see why that changed. This is weird. I didn't change any biomes down below, so I don't know why this has changed since yesterday, but all that is supposed to be that right there. I don't understand. But anyways, yeah, that is what we did. We added in a turret here on the corner for no reason at all. I don't understand why there's a turret there, but there is. Some people suggested in the stream. And then there's a turret right here as well. A little bit more variation. And the spikes on top of the hall really, I think, really help as well. You can see I added in a dormer over here as well, and that there. And then here is the balcony on this side. I added in that sort of, it kind of looks elven in a way, but I think it looks good. I think it works. And I might even do that for here as well, putting in that kind of thing. And maybe along here, same thing as up there. I think I'm gonna keep bringing this style all the way around. It all started with this right here, this bit right there. And I think overall it works, it looks good, and it adds in a certain flair. And if we keep using it across the castle, it'll definitely make it all look better, especially like down on this portion right here. I still need to figure out what I want to do with this, and I might actually try to redo some of this section of the castle. I feel like it's kind of oddly how, you know, it's kind of oddly placed and such how it is right now. I feel like it should be a little cleaner. I like it on this side though, so I really don't know. And then, as I said earlier in my previous segment, I'm definitely going to be revising this whole portion of the castle here. All of this flat area, it's way too small in my opinion. I'm probably going to be adding a fighting area, things like that around, and I think that overall that's going to look much better by the time we are done working with it. So that's going to be some terraforming and some revising to do. Now let's go over here and go inside. I'm pretty sure I showed you everything on the outside, all the changes we've done out here. Oh, there's still one more thing I want to show you. So I am sort of revising this terrain. I'm trying to make it look more uniform in a way. I want to make it look layered. So you can see I have little dark patches of stone kind of going in a layer, and then I have a light patch of stone in the middle, and then I have another dark patch down at the bottom. I've added in some things like this little place where sediment from the water would collect here. This is all sand, so this is all salt water down here, so plants wouldn't grow. This is all due to the better foliage mod, so I still need to figure that out. But then I'm making like little places where the water would crash up and then sort of like digs away at the shore or at the cliff sides. And so that's what you see here, is I'm sort of digging away at the cliff sides, making a sort of invert at the bottom. And other than that, I'm trying to keep the plants up and out of the water, and I think that that overall is looking pretty good. So then over here I've added in some of these bushes. Now they have a sort of blue tint to them because they're in the mushroom biome, at least some of them are, because of these strips of mushroom biome that I've been doing around. So a little, they're just a tad blue, but it also is kind of due to the shaders as well. But that's definitely all right. All right, so the last thing I want to show you that we've updated is we've worked on the hall in here. So let me tell you what's going on here. So before, you guys will remember, this was all open. Let me go ahead and actually turn all that down. All right, so this right here used to be a vault, or, you know, used to be a big open spot, looks down on the dais below. I'm pretty sure it's called a dais, or there's a certain name for the place where the king and the lords and such eat in front of the tables. But anyway, this is the ballroom. This is where the new sort of the music area is going to be. So there's going to be four seats here for different musicians, maybe a couple here on the sides. And I'm thinking about putting in an old piano. I'm not sure though. I think pianos were more of a Renaissance invention. Maybe I'll make another harp in here, because I know that was a invention during the medieval ages, pretty sure. I think that was like in ancient times, because I see like in movies and things like that where they use harps as instruments. But yeah, this here is the ballroom. It's much bigger now, much more grand. It just feels more like a ballroom now. Before it didn't. The roof needs a lot of work. I'm going to be working on making it look better up here. And overall, I think that this is definitely starting to turn out. Then you can come out here on the balcony and look down, all that good stuff. So, and also, going back to balconies, you can go outside here as well and take the view or look out on the fields and things out there. You have balconies either side, so people have plenty of space to go out and catch some air. But let me go ahead and go back down these stairs. And this takes us back down to the dining hall. I know it's kind of dark in there, but so now this is the next thing that I have updated. You'll notice that there's a roof here now, obviously, and some holes here that I still need to fix. I need to figure out. I think that's just, yeah, these are just shadow errors. Those are actually blocks back there, but those are shadow errors. But anyways, This is where the king would sit here, and he has a little hammer to smash his crab legs open or whatever he's eating. I'm guessing clams or oysters, something like that where you would need, or maybe even some kind of like walnut or something hard like that that they have to split open. But I guess all that would already be split for the king. I've also added in this sort of design on the top here. I really like the marble and the red, and I did it on the back too. I felt like that added a much better look overall into this dining hall. I feel like there needs to be more light in here. We can go ahead and do that. I'm not going to do that on camera because it'll take time. So, but anyways, yeah. And then there is this chandelier up here. I'll let you guys take a quick look at that. It's reasonably complex, but it's really simple. You know, it's just putting the wheels down, putting the stuff like that, and overall I think it works pretty well. And then we come back down here, and I think that is all there is to show for this segment of the video. It was mainly just working on this dining hall here, which I really think turned out. And I think what's going to happen is in upcoming parts of this video, we're done with the video now, but with upcoming parts, we're going to be revising this part of the castle here, doing things like that. Oh yes, there is one more thing that I did. I added in this section here. You'll remember this was all just yellow Tudor here, but now I've added in this kind of gable thing up here. It's a little flat right here, so I might try to figure out a way to work with that and make it look better. But for right now, I think that Krine is coming along. It looks like a city. I mean, it looks like a metropolis going on right here. But it's like skyscraper kind of thing going. Now, it's a very fantasy design, and I know that. So also, I kind of want to work with this side. I feel like how this the castle sort of rounds here, it's just too smooth, like especially with that corner tower here. Something just doesn't look right in this area right here. All right, so what I might do is make maybe I'll manipulate the terrain and do something kind of like this over here, possibly, and make like a pillar of terrain and then put a tower on it or something. Because I feel like if that comes out, that would more or less complete that side, and it wouldn't look so, I don't know, it looks so bare on that side. But then again, once we add in this courtyard over here, once we bring that around, I think that in itself will make a much better, make this side much look better, or look much better. And I'm also thinking I might try to manipulate and work on this side here a little bit as well. So we will see what happens. Like, I feel like these little porches here are a little too much. That one there I'm probably going to keep, but that one there I'm not so sure about. I might decide to remove that. But I like the other angles of the castle. I like pretty much all of these angles, all of this angle. You know, especially that angle now that we fixed up this part of the Great Hall there, I think it works out. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you have any suggestions, go ahead and leave in the comments below what you guys think should be added to Krine. I will be continuing this little by little, and a lot of you have been asking about Seabridge as well. Seabridge, you know, it's kind of like a spurt thing. I kind of do things in spurts here and there, and so you might see more on that later on as well. Now, these vines have grown a lot. They aren't supposed to grow. That's one thing that kind of bothers me, is because things grow. There should be more foliage and more detail on these cliffs later on as well, so don't you guys worry. There will be more detail and more things coming in the future. But for right now, we're just going to go ahead and walk down this causeway and enjoy the scenery and see what there is to see. So you guys just sit back and relax.